Ah, the last one to arrive is finally here. I hope you don't think you're special. It would be a shame if it went to your head. But you somehow got the idea you didn't need to pass your trials to become Sith. Lord Zash has tasked me with sorting through refuse to find one worthy of being her apprentice, and I intend to do just that.
Don't get all sentimental, we've only just met.
I won't. Now the rest of you gutter trash already know your trial. Get going while I bring our latecomer up to speed.
Watch your back, and don't worry, it'll be all right. He can't kill us all.
Thanks. That means a lot coming from a beautiful girl.
Just watch you don't get yourself killed.
Now, Steve, for your trial. There's a hermit named Spindrol who lives in the tomb of Ajunta Paul in the Valley of the Dark Lords. Spindrol's a lunatic, but Lord Zash sees him as some kind of prophet. Once you find him, he will test you.
I'll do my best to please Spindrol and accomplish this trial.
But there, you know your task. Spindrol lives in the tomb of Ajunta Paul in the Valley of the Dark Lords. Don't keep Spindrol waiting, slave.
Excuse me, Acolyte. Sergeant Corman, 5th Infantry Company, Corriban Regiment. Can I talk to you?
Speaking, Sergeant.
Thank you. You're one of the slaves Harkon brought in on the last transport, right? Here to prove yourself to the bloodthirsty overseers?
Prove myself or die, apparently.
Well, here's your chance to not only show off for the overseers, but start getting ties to the Imperial military as well. I'm here commanding a hard-target mission to exterminate claw slugs in this tomb. They're horrific things. Mouths bigger than your head. I've lost 3 squads of good men fighting them. They come in packs. They'll swallow a man whole.
Then I suggest you try a new strategy.
Look, I've identified the enemy's weak spot, but it's not easy to get at. The damn claw slugs breed so fast there's no way to wipe them out conventionally. So we started targeting their egg chambers. They went insane. We managed to get explosives to all of the egg chambers, but the claw slugs were all over it before we could detonate them.
Sounds like you need some help.
Don't underestimate those claw slugs, sir. They're smarter than they look. I heard the explosions when you set off the charges. Outstanding, sir.
Oh! Slave, welcome to my humble hovel. You are here for your trial, yes? Learn the ways of the Sith from the doddering old man in a tomb, and hopefully to return to your master with the mark of my approval.
Yes, my lord, that's right.
Of course it is. I know the way things on the surface. But before I answer either way, you must pass a trial of blood. Survive, and I will teach you what I know. Excellent. These former acolytes want nothing more than to earn their second chance for glory by killing you and taking your place. But your desire proved stronger, and their blood became the mantle of your victory. Well done. But you are not Sith yet. Peace is a lie. There is only passion. Through passion I gain strength. Through strength, through power, victory. Through victory, my chains are broken. This is the Sith Code. Commit it to your heart, and you will have the strength to crush your enemies. Do you understand?
Of course. I was born to be Sith.
Good. Then go. Return to Harkon and nurture your hatred for him. And use your fear of him to grow stronger. He may raise his fist to strike, but it is Lord Zash who determines where the blow will land.
But who controls Zash, I wonder?
When you know the answer to that, you will have power over both your masters. Now, go. Leave me to my rest.
I have taken care of your problem with the looters in the tomb.
Ah, then I'll assume my men are dead. Even so, you have done us a great service. Their loss is your gain, I suppose.
I am most grateful.
Yes, sir.
Ah! Meet our newcomer, Fon Alt. This is really Sith strength, and he'll tear you apart and crush your bones, slaves. Look on him. No connections left in the world. Pure Sith blood. This is Lord Zash's future apprentice, not filth like you.
We'll see how tough he is out on the tombs, alone, with just being a blade for company.
Step this way, slave. I'll speak to you privately.
The rest of you, get out here. You know no trials.
You too, Fon. Spindle awaits. Now, listen to me. Spindle is a lunatic. His approval means nothing. You are filth, and you die. Is that clear?
You think you scare me?
You are nothing, and don't forget it. Now, your second trial. Lord Zash has requested a special trial for you, which you will no doubt fail.
Go to Inquisitor's Inn in the jails. He will fill you in on the details, and most likely hasten your demise.
I don't die easily.
Don't boast, slave.
I don't want to see you again until you're back from the jails. That's all.
These new recruits are worthless. Raggots, children, slaves.
Acolyte, you've arrived. And not a moment too soon. Hakan has given me very specific instructions. You were raised as a slave, but must discard those traits and learn to control others. And I have just the task for that end. Meet this dribbling excuse for an hour. He will be your victim.
Victim, huh? This sounds like it could be fun.
This is not an idle diversion, Acolyte. A short while ago, there was what we call an unauthorized murder here in the Academy. A rivalry among apprentices resulted in death. Interrogate him. Make him tell you who committed this crime at any cost.
Cover your ears. This may get a little loud.
Thank you for the warning, but I prefer to cherish every scream.
Please, don't hurt me. I don't know anything.
Scream, weakling. I want to hear your suffering.
Please, don't do that again. I'll do anything.
Entertain me. Give me a song or something.
Sing? Are you serious? I mean, sure. Yes, I... What should I...
Something in the higher registers.
Stop! Please! All right, I'll talk. You'll kill me, but I'll talk. The murderer is an apprentice named Essor Kayan. You have to protect me, or he'll kill me.
I doubt that. He'll be too busy being punished for murder.
Kayan's master is a Dark Council member. Might as well try fighting the Emperor himself. Kayan won't get so much as a reprimand. When Kayan finds out, he'll come after me.
Maybe then you'll shut up.
Of course, it's not your problem. Why should you care? Maybe if I'm lucky, Kayan will put me out quickly.
You don't have to tell me. I heard the name loud and clear, though I sorely wish I hadn't. Essor Kayan. Kayan's master is a Dark Councilor. I'd be a fool to oppose him. But anyway, your trial here is done. I will send my commendations to Overseer Hakan. You may return to him now.
What, no more torture? Oh, but I was just getting started.
I know. It's so hard to stop once you've started. Perhaps later, if you survive your trials. It has been most pleasant watching you work, Acolyte. Truly, I wish you best of luck in your remaining trials.
Forward to cutting another one of you down, but it looks like I'll be spared the trouble. Unsurprisingly, Nylock has gone missing. Also, unsurprisingly, Fon has passed his first trial. It's only a matter of time before he tramples you all underfoot.
I'll tear you apart where you stand, slave.
Patience, Fon. An accident in the tombs is much more convincing. If you know your next task, go. I want to speak to Fon and our latecomer. Now, slave. Zin says you handled yourself expertly, and as much as I find it difficult to believe, Lord Zash is satisfied with his evaluation. Undoubtedly, Zin helped you in some way, but you will not have his help on the next trial. Both you and Fon will have trials of intellect, trials that test your ability to apply your understanding of force to solve problems.
You don't expect a slave to be a match for me in intellect. I've been trained under the greatest teachers.
Calm down, Fon. I certainly do not expect this slave to be a match for you. That's why you will have separate trials.
Truly, your generosity astounds.
You're only digging your own grave. Fon, you will go to the library on the second floor of the academy and translate the following texts for Lord Zash.
Yes, Overseer.
Slave, deep in the ancient, monster-infested tomb of Marka Ragnos, there is a holocron filled with dark secrets and encased in a great stone monument. No one has figured out how to release the holocron from its stone prison in over 1,000 years. You will bring this holocron to me, or you will die.
The more you make me hate you, the stronger I become, Harkon. And one of these days I'm going to be strong enough to crush you.
You will never be strong enough, slave. You will bring back the holocron, or hope that the spirit of Marka Ragnos himself returns to end your miserable existence. Now go.
Stand and account for yourself, Acolyte. Let's see what you're made of. And I wonder, are you among the truly loyal, or do you hide treason in your heart?
Do you always make a habit of accusing strangers of treachery and sedition?
You are no stranger to me. I know everyone in this academy, even its former slaves. Intelligence reports indicate this valley shelters traitors. Acolytes who seek to destroy our Emperor's carefully built order and replace it with their own weak-minded heresies.
They hide among the faithful and obedient. But make no mistake, they will destroy us all, given the chance.
We've watched as the traitors scuttle about this valley and plot against us. We know their faces and their names. It is the Emperor's will that the sands of Korriban be slaked with the blood of these traitors. Prove your allegiance by executing them.
It will be a great honor to serve you, my lord.
And in serving me, you serve the Emperor. Remember that as you exterminate those vermin in the valley.
I'll give you the means to identify the traitors. Eliminate enough of them to prove your loyalty. Then return to Inquisitor Arzanen.
I'll be watching your progress with great interest. Go now. See that the Emperor's will be done. I watched you deal with those traitors. Well done. That was an impressive display of loyalty. Take this reward as a token of the Emperor's favor, and wear this badge. It marks you as a defender of our empire.
Stay vigilant. Our enemies lurk where you least expect them.
A fresh, young acolyte come to view my experiments. Good. I trust the sight of a messy operating table doesn't disturb you.
The path to power is not for the faint-hearted.
You remind me of myself at your age. This used to be a Kata, the hound-like creatures infesting Korriban's tombs. On the surface, nothing special. But I alone can see this creature is an expression of pure, dark side energy. Aggression made manifest.
Amazing. How did you learn that?
The Force told me so. It speaks to me. The Force is alive. It expresses its will in the physical world. This Tukata was one such form.
Are we another of these forms?
Sith are the highest manifestation of the Force's will. I've dissected hundreds of Tukata, forging a direct connection to the dark side. Each beast I examine advances me toward perfect unity. I now stand at a new frontier, but find myself thwarted. My most perfect specimen, a Tukata mutant, escaped to the tombs before I could analyze it.
Perhaps I can help you recover your specimen.
Yes, I was hoping as much. My apprentice, Melora, saw which tomb the mutant beast fled into. Find out what she knows, assist me, and you will be rewarded.
I'll stay, Melora, and do whatever is necessary, my lord.
You found a great calling in my service. I trust you appreciate that.
Seeking Lord Renning's lost pet, are you? Don't waste your time. That fool's research is pointless.
Not a very loyal apprentice.
He's my title only. He has nothing to teach anyone about the dark side of the Force. Renning deludes the Dark Council into believing he's advancing Sith knowledge. The truth is, he wastes the Empire's time and resources dissecting mindless animals. But if his experiments were discredited, he would be banished, and I would be rewarded.
How exactly is telling me supposed to help?
Look, just a minor alteration to the mutant Tukata's brain would allow me to reveal my master as a fraud. Bring me the brain before delivering it to Lord Renning, and I'll make it worth your while.
I'm sure there's some way we could work this out.
Perfect. Then we have an agreement. The mutant Tukata escaped to the tomb of Mark of Ragnos. It's much larger than the others, so it's easy to spot. Return to me with the brain before you see Lord Renning, and I'll take care of the rest.
Hey, friend. If you're headed out by the Tukata, Lord Varrison is paying actual credits for bone marrow samples. Varrison's doing some sort of experiment for Lord Renning. The less details we know, the better, I'm sure.
Sergeant Garrus. We lost down here aren't dead. They lost their minds, just like the acolytes. Doesn't mean we're gonna have any easier a time getting the research supplies back, though. The crates are secured with multi-locks. If we're going to open these things without frying the contents, we need to get all the sentries' code cylinders back. I don't think negotiation is an option. The men aren't keen to take down their old comrades, but we'll do what we can. Once we have the code cylinders, we'll crack open the supply crates and get back. Tavon out.
The power of the dark side is in me. Perhaps a little blood will satiate you. Perhaps calm is necessary. Just open, damn it.
Ah, more bone marrow samples. Lord Renning will be pleased. You may go.
I'm running out of patience. Have you finally acquired the mutant Tukata brain, or should I send someone else?
I got what you wanted.
Ha! Let me see it.
I'm sure you'll find it satisfactory.
Look at the mottling along the frontal lobe. Oh, I can't wait to analyze this. You've done me a great service, but now I must continue my research. If there's nothing else?
Melora asked me to sabotage your experiment.
Is that so? Melora? Show my work creation it deserves. There's no place for you as my apprentice.
Wait, Master. It's a lie. I haven't betrayed you.
I know the truth when I hear it, Melora. I'm releasing you from my service.
Eventually.
Master, please.
My dear. The pain for you is only beginning. Take your reward and leave. Melora and I have to discuss.
Sounds like you need some help.
I appreciate your kind offer, but I prefer to handle this myself. Farewell.
Yes, can I help you with something? Hold on. Are those the research supplies we were after? I'd given up on them days ago. You've no idea how much I appreciate this. Some of these chemicals take months to manufacture. Not much use to you, but vital to us. Thank you. You're welcome to use some of our equipment as compensation. I'll make sure to mention you to the commander.
You better not be wasting my time, slave. You better have the holocron. A fake. All stolen from the library, probably. I'll deal with you later. Now, I believe it's time for another demonstration. Gurr, step forward.
Yes, Overseer.
Fon, kill him.
With pleasure, Overseer.
Let Gurr be an example to you. Fon destroyed him easily, like he will destroy all of you. Are there any other objections?
You are only giving us power, Harkon.
And your comments are only hastening your death, slave. Now the rest of you know the next trial. Go. You, slave, stay here. Now, slave, you think yourself pretty clever getting that holocron, don't you?
Stop with your taunts and give me my next trial.
If you wish to prolong your life, you will not make demands of me again, slave. Now for your trial. The last, darkest secrets of Tulak Horde are buried in his tomb. Lord Zash wants this text. But the final resting place of the dead lord is not easily trespassed. You will not be the first to die there.
Yes, yes, yes. You send me into a tomb to do the impossible, hoping I die, and I come back and prove you wrong.
Shut up, slave! I've had about enough of your mockery. Do not come back here until you've gotten the text from Tulak Horde's tomb. Out of my sight, slave!
So, yet another acolyte stands in the shadow of our academy. You must consider yourself privileged. Tell me, you who would be Sith, have you seen much of our civilization so far? Have you been awed by this world's power and glory?
All I've seen is dust and tombs. Not very impressive.
Then you have not been blinded by your master's claims. Korriban was wrought by the true-blooded Sith millennia ago. Our ancestors, a crimson race of conquerors, raised the statues around us. Over the eons, however, our people mingled with slaves. Now the red markings of true Sith are rare, and the purity of this planet is in question.
You're mingling with a former slave right now.
Is that so? This is a sad day, but you may yet be useful. True purity and strength are carried in the blood. I worry that our blood is being diluted over generations. In the Emperor's name, I have come to learn whether the Academy's overseers are Sith or not. You will be an instrument.
It would be an honor.
It is a glorious opportunity. I possess an ancient device, a holocron, that can read and record bloodlines. It will pulse life near the overseers. Allow the holocron to fulfill its purpose. Stand near the overseers as it attunes to their blood purity. Then return here, and I will learn the truth.
I have need of you, young one. Whatever errand your master sent you on can wait until we are through.
My master can rot for all I care.
Then it's time you had some direction. I am Inquisitor Urinth, and I represent the intelligence operations of the Sith. We are currently holding an important Jedi prisoner, a spy who attempted to reach this academy. We have plans for him. Upon capture, we found the Jedi's mind simple to manipulate. We fed him false memories through a combination of drugs and sorcery. Soon he will return to his Jedi commanders and report the lies we fed him. He will know nothing of what we've done. All that remains is to stage his escape.
How do you propose to do that?
You are young enough, new enough, to be a plausible traitor. You will go to the Jedi, talk to him, do as he asks, earn his trust. When that is done, set him free. Do whatever is necessary to get him out of prison. We will ensure that he reaches his ship and returns safely to his Jedi friends.
How do I know you won't accuse me of treason?
Prove your strength. Prove that you are truly Sith. And all the accusations in the world will mean nothing. You will find the Jedi Corian Dorjus in the jail cells. He is still confused and should not be overly difficult to convince. Come here, child. Do you intend to explore the Academy? To know the world that gave birth to the Sith? You should linger here a while. I am Overseer Raggate, a keeper of the old ways. I sense you have potential, and I can help you if you like.
Everyone in the Academy seems to sense my potential.
But you have not yet come into your own. You have power and strength in the Force. But you must be tested beyond the trials your masters have set for you. I administer the rite of blood and bone, a ritual performed beyond this doorway. It is a rite acolytes have participated in for 10,000 years.
You have my complete undivided attention.
In the chambers past the gateway, there is a colony of Shyrax, my leather-winged razor-taloned children and their brood. They guard a mountain of skulls, an altar to the Academy's failures. You must reach the bones before proceeding.
You promised a rite of blood and bone. Where's the blood?
Clever, cruel child. I have your answer. You must claim a skull from the mountain and return to the antechamber. Soak the skull in the blood pool and come to me. Once bone has turned red, I will look and see your nature written in crimson stains. And possibly a glimpse of your future.
I'll admit that does sound intriguing.
To complete the rite is to accept one's death, to steal one's own mortality and drown it in the fluid of life. That is the symbolic purpose. But it is also a trial of power. As are all Sith trials, a trial to test strength and to grant it. I will await you here. If you die, I will forget you. Heard the screams of the Shyrax and the rippling of the blood pool. I heard the sounds of death. I know you brought the red-stained skull, and I must say, I am pleased.
It was actually quite simple.
Then you have a darker heart than most. The skull you carry, your rage, your actions drowned it with the dark side. It is part of you. I can read it. I can offer a small gift, but more than that, I can offer a glimpse of your destiny. There's much I can read in the bones.
Who am I to turn down free advice?
Very well. Listen carefully. When your final trial comes, beware the Shadow Killer. It can be bound, but never controlled.
I am most grateful.
That is all I see for certain. I can say no more. Prize what you have accomplished here. You are part of a tradition almost as old as Corriban itself. And you have done well. Goodbye now, young Sith. This lesson is complete.
There is no emotion. There is peace. There is no ignorance. There is knowledge. The Jedi Code will guide me.
I take it you're the Jedi who was captured.
I'm Corian Dorjus. I'm a Jedi. Even here. Even on Corriban. Why do you care? Why are you here?
No one should have to suffer like that.
You mean that? A Sith with a conscience? You're here to help me. Why am I talking in circles? What's wrong with me?
The Inquisitors are messing with your mind. They pumped you full of drugs.
I suspected as much. It's so hard to think straight. There's no passion. There's serenity. There's no chaos. There's harmony. The Jedi Code will guide me. I can focus. If you want to help me escape, I'll need my belongings, my lightsaber, my comlink. Before I was captured, the Sith chased me into the tomb of Tulak Horde. I hid my belongings inside an urn to light my load. That is where you'll need to go.
You must be one of the slave acolytes. Pretty easy to see why Overseer Harkon was horrified. Regardless, Lord Zash has made it clear that all new acolytes must learn martial skills as well as face their trials. Though why anyone thinks you can be taught is beyond me.
I assume someone a bit more learned will be instructing me.
Someone with a bit less pull, you mean? Not for all the credits in the world. You will find the instructors in the Academy's archive. Hurry, and try not to embarrass your betters.
Come closer, acolyte. The wind outside has torn my ears to tatters, and my eyes grow strained and bloody in the dark. I've studied this tomb for years, slept on its stones, and dreamed of its depths. Now, I need assistance to solve its final mystery.
Who are you?
I am Efren Zell. For generations, my family has studied the tombs of Corriban, traveling from one to the next to learn the history of the Sith. This tomb is the final resting place of Tulak Horde. The tomb's maze was built to his precise specifications. But he built his maze to hold more than just his body. He built it to secure his greatest creation, his terrible machine, the Red Engine.
Keep going. What Red Engine?
The machine was his life's work. A perfect puzzle that hid all his secrets. It was a vault and a library all at once. The scholars in the Academy, they say the Red Engine was never completed. They say it never functioned. But I know how it works, and I know how to fuel it.
Then why not inform the scholars?
They think that I, not a Sith, nor an educated man, man couldn't discover the truth. They ignore my findings and are blinded by arrogance. Listen now. Anyone can activate the red engine, but unless it receives its sacrifice, it will only sputter and die. The machine needs blood and hatred to become fully operational. If a Sith could slay the tomb's beast in its presence, their deaths would be its fuel. Find the machine within the tomb. Work its mechanisms. And when at last it reveals Tulak Horde's secrets, I beg of you, bring me its scripture. Bring me the knowledge I have dreamed of.
Those blasted mining droids were tougher than I thought. I'm not going to make it, but I hope whoever is watching this will honor me. Escaped slaves stole weapons from the Academy, fled into this tomb. They've reprogrammed the mining droids. Without those droids, the slaves won't survive. Tried to take them down myself. Didn't work out. Destroy enough rogue droids, and the slaves will die. Teach them not to cross the Sith.
Step forward. I assume you've completed my task. I will take the holocron now. It is time we judge the purity of your overseer's blood. Time we know how much of the ancients survive in their veins.
I couldn't agree more.
The holocron, it glows white. So little Sith blood in all of the Academy. And only one of the overseers wears the red marks. This is shameful. I will bring this to the attention of the Dark Council. Measures must be taken if the true Sith are to survive.
What's your plan?
I'll advise purges and enslavement of those with the thinnest blood. And uplift the pure. It will be the Dark Council's decision, however. You have served well. It is too late for me to alter your training. But in the future, perhaps acolytes will kneel at the feet of the pure-blooded.
Ah, approach. I've heard rumors of your exploits in the tombs. You follow in the footsteps of failed apprentices. Ones sent to slay renegades and crack the shells of armored droids. You fared better.
I crushed my enemies underfoot.
No doubt it was satisfying. The mining droids not only protected the slaves who subverted their program, but threatened to damage the tombs of the ancients. That would have been unforgivable. And for succeeding where others died, you will be rewarded.
What dark secret shall I share with you? Be gone.
I know you. We talked before. My head's clearer now, Sith. It's all here. The comlink, my lightsaber, everything I hid. You're going through with it. With all this, once the guards change shifts, I think I can slip out of the Academy. But what about you? Will you be okay?
Me? I'll be fine. I'm more worried about you.
That's very kind of you, Sith. I still don't understand why you're doing this, but I thank you.
If it's a trap, your memories have been altered. When you report to the Jedi, you'll tell them exactly what the Sith want you to.
What? Then that explains why you would help me out, at least, but not why you would tell me the truth. It isn't important now, but I will speak to my masters of this. For the moment, I should go. I'm sorry the Empire took you in instead of the Jedi. If things had been different, maybe you could have been part of the Order.
So the Jedi is preparing his escape. You did well. Not perfectly, but I have confidence the operation will succeed. Our business is concluded. I will make note of your assistance in my report.
What about the Jedi? Will he be safe?
No Jedi is safe. Sooner or later, the Empire will destroy the Order entirely. Take these tokens as payment for your service. and know that no Jedi can threaten Korriban. Now go.
Remarkable. Magnificent. You slave, what? No, acolyte. You're the one who brought me this magnificent holocron from the tomb of Mark Aragnos, yes?
Yes, my lord. I found the holocron.
Unbelievable. 1,000 years buried in that tomb, the Sith lords passing it by, and then the most unlikely person comes along. Tell me, how did you manage it?
I shot lightning at it and it opened.
Such a simple solution. Why did none of us think of that? We must have thought too deeply on it, believed too strongly that it could not be done. Or perhaps we were simply not meant to open it. Your work so far, in bringing back this holocron, and now the text from Tulak Horde's tomb, has me intrigued. I am watching your progress eagerly. I have high hopes for you, acolyte. Sky high.
Really? Harkon seems to favor Fawn.
Harkon's only purpose is to weed out the weak. Beyond that, his opinion means nothing. Good luck, acolyte. Good luck.
I was just about to send Fawn off. What delayed you, slave?
Well, First Lord Zash stopped me to tell me how amazing I am, and then we got talking, and I suppose I lost track of time.
Just like a slave to make up stories. Lord Zash would crush you like a Gizkar if you ever crossed her path. You're not worthy of her presence. Now, did you collect the text from Tulak Horde's tomb?
Of course. As always, I'm brilliant.
Give it here. No doubt it's been badly damaged. It's what we get for sending a careless lowlife to do a Sith job. Isn't that right, Fawn?
What are we waiting for, Overseer? Why don't we kill this wretch now?
You have a big mouth, slave, but no combat skills. I don't want to see you again until you've satisfied the Korriban instructors. The training facility is on the second floor of the academy and is usually reserved for the Dark Lords and their apprentices. This is not a promotion, and you are not to speak to anyone except the training master when you are up there, understand? You are not fit for their presence.
Please tell me Fawn can come. We'll have so much fun.
Fawn has been training at combat his whole life. He was born to be Sith. You are just as likely to chop your own arm off as not, slave. Now get going to the second floor training grounds. You don't want to keep the instructors waiting.
Hello there, friend. You remember my brother and me from downstairs? With Harkon, right?
Sorry it had to be this way.
We don't like it any more than you do. Well, maybe a little more.
This sounds vaguely like a threat. What did I ever do to you?
I'm sorry, man. I liked you. I really did.
But Harker made us a deal, see? We kill you, we go home.
You will regret that.
We don't want to. But we know we can't beat Fon, and we'll never be Sith. At least this way we can go home, alive.
Quiet, Baelic. The time for talk is past. Fight for your life, Acolyte.
Look who shows up at long last. I half expected to hear you'd crossed some Dark Lord upstairs and finally got yourself killed. None of the others have shown up either. I assume they're dead by now, which means you and Fon are the last ones.
So I just killed Fon and I'm Sith, right? This shouldn't take long.
Wrong. Your final trial will be to retrieve an ancient map from the innermost chamber of Naga Sado's tomb, which has never been breached in thousands of years. But before you get the map, you'll have to awaken an ancient assassin called a Dashard that sleeps in the tomb. You cannot access the map without him, understand?
I think I can do that much.
Oh, and one more thing. You'll be competing with Fon for this map. Whoever brings it back will be Lord Zash's apprentice. The other will die. And Fon's already started, so my advice? Run, slave. Run.
One moment, please.
Lord Zash! What are you doing here?
Overseer, are you implying that I, a Lord of the Sith, don't have the right to go where I please within the Academy of the Sith?
No. Of course not, Lord Zash.
Good. I saw the last acolyte arrive. I wanted to see the hopefuls off on their final trial. Where's, the red one, Fon?
He finished his trial early, so I sent him on rather than keep him waiting for this.
Pity. I just finished translating the wonderful text this acolyte brought from Tulak Horde's tomb, and it's most illuminating. I don't know that the map can be retrieved without it.
Well, well, well. It's a good thing I didn't start running, isn't it, Harkon?
It's too late. Fon's already left. You can't just...
Give one acolyte an unfair advantage over the other? Overseer, when has being Sith ever been about being fair? Now, my dear acolyte, here is what you must do to free the Dashard. There are rods scattered throughout the tomb of Naga Sado. These rods are the keys to the chamber where the ancient assassin is imprisoned. You will need to place the rods in the chamber door and electrify them. I don't know exactly the reason, but it is clear that you will not be able to retrieve the map without the Dashard. But be careful. He is very dangerous.
Is there anything else I should know about the Dashard?
It's a force-resistant assassin. I have reason to believe this one was placed in the tomb by Tulak Horde himself. I will return when both acolytes are back from the tomb. You will not do anything further to affect the outcome of the trial. Understood?
Yes, Lord Zash.
Good. And good luck, acolyte.
Acolyte, may I speak to you for a moment?
For a beauty like yourself, of course.
Oh, yes. Thank you. You're too kind, really. There was another acolyte, not long ago, who entered this tomb and did not come back. He died in there.
And you were worried to see a handsome man like me die too?
No, I mean, not that... That's not what I meant. I mean, it's just that... The acolyte who went in there, he was a good sort. Friendly and talkative. He said he was entering the tomb to prove himself to his father. I just thought it would be nice if somebody took his body back and told his father he didn't make it.
Yes, the father should be told that his son has fallen.
I'd never survive in there. And even if I did, I wouldn't be allowed to see his father. He is a Dark Honor Guard stationed in the Academy. None but Sith can ever set foot on the sacred ground where he stands watch. But you could find the body and bring it to his father. Please, do this and honor the fallen.
If I see the Acolyte's body, I will try to retrieve it.
Thank you so much. If you find the Acolyte's remains inside the tomb, let me know. I can tell you where to find his father in the Academy. Good luck.
What exactly are you? I too am despised in the Academy. What happened then?
Maru, your guest, the guest,
If Prythor is the one who exiled you to these caves, I doubt he'll change his mind about feeding you. I'll do everything in my power.
Found him. That poor acolyte.
He got torn up pretty badly in there.
He was so brave and ready to prove himself to his father. His father was Naaman Fall. As I said before, he's one of the Dark Honor Guards in the Academy. If you take the acolyte's remains to his father, I'm sure he'll be grateful.
Sounds like a worthy cause.
Thank you. It's good to see that there are more feelings embraced by the Sith than just hate and fury. You can find the Acolyte's father outside the chamber of the Dark Council. That's where he stands guard.
You don't belong here. You stand before the chamber of the Dark Council, and this floor is off-limits to all who are not lords of the Sith. If you are not on official business, you will leave now.
I've come with news about your son.
So that is the smell you carry. It is said he went into the tomb of Naga Sadao to prove himself, and was killed. He was such a weak boy. He shames me in death as he shamed me in life. When I heard of his death, I could not leave my post. Honor forbade it. Still, I would like to know what happened in there.
Of course. Ask away, my lord.
Your deference does you credit. Now tell me, where did you find his body? Did my pathetic son even make it past the first steps? In the end, was he Sith?
He died valiantly, deep in the tombs. He was nearly Sith.
He died well. I suppose my son had more of me in his heart than I had ever considered possible. With this news, you have brought me a peace I didn't think possible. Thank you. I will have him buried in honor. Take this small token of my appreciation and go.
What do you want? I'm training slaves to feed the beasts, and I don't have time to chat.
I'm here for a special meal. You know the kind.
You've been talking to Seyrun, haven't you? That creature was close to me when I was an acolyte. It helped me survive my trials. It traveled places I couldn't, told me everything it heard and saw. It had been living off vermin before I came along. I figured out a way to make it healthier, stronger. Seyrun's special meals.
What is Seyrun exactly? I've never seen anything like it.
Its people come from the planet Biss, but it's lived on Korriban as long as anyone can remember. Seyrun never knew exactly what I fed it. Its meals weren't just beast fodder. Seyrun ate the corpses of the Academy's failures, the bones and blood of dead acolytes. Feeding on their energy after death, it grew exponentially more powerful with every meal, and became strong in the dark side.
No good can come of this.
Pity I didn't have your insight at the time. When I saw how twisted Seyrun was becoming, I sent it away. It was becoming hungrier all the time, and I feared it would attack the living. Destroying it seemed impossible. It could heal any injury it suffered. I hoped it would find a new home somewhere. But it seems we must act more decisively.
We could. Or I could give it the meat at once.
Aid Seyrun and it will turn on us. One more taste of power and it will begin hunting acolytes. I can't allow that. Together, we must poison Seyrun. Before I sent Seyrun away, I developed a powerful toxin. But I didn't have the heart to use it. It won't kill the creature, but it should strip it of its power.
So let's say we poison it. What happens to Seyrun then?
My best guess? If we do this, Seyrun won't survive much longer. It will hide as best it can and slowly starve. But the alternative is to let it become a living horror.
Then let's poison that thing.
I'm glad you see it as I do. I'm giving you this meat. Don't ask me where it came from, but it should fool Seyrun. Once the poison is in its system, it will weaken. I take no satisfaction in this, but it is necessary.
Maru, your guest must take his kid in your mission table, ma.
I'm sure you'll find it satisfactory. I did what was necessary. Leave this evil place, Seyrun. Leave the Academy, and leave Korriban if you can. It's no place for you.
after them.
Places Amin's wise fools. Go and Dida seek from Tauhans. Taukida, Melaswe Sama, word sign in Merem Nai, Saigatrawa Deda. Chagasar Chais, and Barks, prize war Peren, Swase Ikbus, Karadida.
These were the instructions Zash gave me. I am to free you, and you will take me to the map in the final chamber of the tomb.
Ababarna Habans, Glaubena, Ni in Usakwai, Usi Terrens Apipao. Was Jabe wise Jabe, Prophetis, Wisan Jagara Haitain.
I hate to be the one to break it to you, but Tulak Horde is dead.
The places Amin's Waihais fools, go and Dida seek from Tauhans. Paprogatua. Ina in Laosolam, Jagasa Dida Duima. Twade in Warpai an Parlai Kain. Kudana, Jaus Erpai Rojanan, in Bise Wistai. In Bizose Waitais Bila Presin Kretai, in Bise Ewanata, Atrakata Injais.
I am your master. Get used to it.
Sisunja, Targi Skolan.
I'm telling you, Overseer, it cannot be done. I went into the tomb, I saw the Dashard across the chasm, but I could not get to it.
But the map, the map! Lord Zash is adamant she will not take an apprentice without the map!
I'm telling you, Lord Zash wants the impossible. No one is ever going to get that map!
No one except me, you mean?
The map, and the Dashard! Get that monster out of here this instant! And give me the map!
No, it's not possible. You wretch, you filth! You must have cheated somehow. How did you do it? How did you release the monster?
Sai galuf saida, iswis us ulf bendan ja atnam in puidangar ja.
Right. You must have cheated. You must have. You'll pay for this!
Fawn, patience. You will have your chance at this whelp after you personally deliver this map to Lord Zash.
Eat them both, Kim.
They'll be the wisdom.
Keep your pet at bay for just a moment, Acolyte. I would have a word with Fawn.
Lord Zash?
Yes, Fawn. Now, where's my map?
Here, Lord Zash. Right here.
You found it for me, Fawn? How wonderful.
You are one dead man.
Silence! Fawn will tell me what happened, won't you, Fawn? You wouldn't dare lie to me, would you? Because it would be a shame for me to discover that you lied to me. Now, one more time. Did you bring this map back from Nagasado's tomb?
I didn't. I'm sorry.
Hearken, you fool. In any other group, for any other lord, this young man would have torn the other acolytes to shreds. What were you trying to prove? That you could outsmart me? That you knew better than me what kind of person I wanted for an apprentice? You fool! There's your pet, Harkon. Clean this mess up. Apprentice, meet me in my chambers upstairs.
As you say.
This is not the end. Without Lord Zash to save you, you're nothing. I have connections that will hunt you wherever you go.
I'm sorry it turned out this way, Harkon. I know you never liked me much, but I learned a lot from you.
What? Well, I guess it is an overseer's job to inspire his charges. Now get going, slave. I mean, apprentice.
Ah, my magnificent new apprentice. Congratulations are in order, I believe.
Thank you for giving me this opportunity.
You've earned it, my apprentice. Now, I was just looking over this astonishing map you brought back, and I can tell we have a lot of work ahead of us.
Murder and mayhem await.
Patience, my apprentice. We must go about this with tact. All in good time. You must meet me on Drummond Cars. There we can talk more.
Why must we go there?
That is where the map leads, though I likely would have taken you there anyway. The capital of the Sith Empire is a good place for an apprentice to start. I will meet you in my chambers in the Citadel in Cars City. There we can speak more freely of the work ahead, without the fear of unfriendly ears. This is the lightsaber I had as an apprentice. I want you to have it.
I shall wreak havoc with it wherever I go.
Magnificent. No doubt you will. Now, remember, my chambers, the Citadel, Drummond Cass. It's imperative that we get to work on this as soon as possible.
Stop right there, slave. Darth Scotia has a message for you.
I am a Sith apprentice. Show some respect or I'll smash your face in.
Shut up, you insignificant worm! The message is this. You will not go to Drummond Cass. Everything you've done here, everyone you've dealt with, Lord Zash included, is insignificant. Darth Scotia has eyes and ears on Corriban. He knows what your master is up to, and he is displeased, to say the least. On Corriban, Lord Zash may have her way, but on Drummond Cass it's a different story. So you see, you have to die.
Kem, what is it you do to Force users again?
Gibai Iswis Aman Hanguijins.
Ortosin, is that a Dashard? Maybe this isn't such a good idea.
Coward! Fight, you fool!
Oh!
You are a powerful figure on the galactic stage. Powerful figures attract powerful enemies. Shield yourself from your enemies. Broaden your sphere of influence. Wield your prosperity as a weapon. Accomplish all of this and more with strongholds. Procure a location from across the galaxy to construct your new power base. Adorn your stronghold in stunning opulence. And immerse yourself in gratification as the seething resentment and abject fear of your adversaries wash over you. Be ever in service to the Empire. Show your worth. Brandish your power. Secure a stronghold now.
A pleasure to greet you, my lord. I am MQ-12, liaison to the Ministry of War's Mercenary Recruitment Division. I find appropriate employment for talented freelance soldiers serving the Empire. Would you be interested in acquiring a combatant who achieved a perfect score on the Megas Aggression Index?
I've never heard of this Aggression Index before. Explain it.
The test measures an individual's psychological predisposition toward violence and effectiveness at channeling hostility during combat encounters. Perfect scores are exceedingly rare. The Science Bureau has classified this mercenary as a hopelessly primitive creature from an undeveloped outer rim system, but judged it as useful nonetheless. It has previously served Imperial interests on Nar Shaddaa, and displayed noteworthy commitment to our cause by eliminating a dozen resistance groups on Balmora.
Either this mercenary is good, or Balmora's resistance fighters are inept. Which is it?
Perhaps both. As you will see, the individual's physical qualities can camouflage its intentions. Judge for yourself. It understands our language well enough, and will respond in its own crude fashion. The subject calls itself Treak.
You're eager to serve. Do you know what it means to bind your fate to a Sith Lord? Welcome to my crew, Treak. Your contract with me begins immediately. Ready?
Kobaji jajabo. Amisoro bagavindija papukoja. Karani kete abdos oyachi. Parikrama rada kavakulaya. Bandaleloso isatamini alininia.
I am pleased you found my offering worthwhile, my lord. I will report our success to the Ministry of War. Good day.